गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू आर यूट्यूब चैनल घंटा स्टडी, घंटों का ज्ञान मिनटों में। टुडे वी प्रेजेंट टू यू द डेली करंट अफेयर्स ऑफ 30 सितंबर 2018। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। आर फर्स्ट न्यूज इज महात्मा गांधी इंटरनेशनल सैनिटेशन कन्वेंशन। सो दिस वॉज इन कन्वेंशन विच वॉज हेल्ड एंड इट वॉज इनॉग्रेटेड बाई प्रेजिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया, हु इज रामनाथ कोविंद। Inaugurated Mahatma Gandhi International Sanitation Convention, and what he said, he says Swachh Bharat is a revolution playing out in real time. So on the occasion he said that achieving universal access to adequate and equitable sanitation and hygiene by 2030 is a major challenge in many parts of the world. As we have seen that sanitation is a major problem and maintaining hygiene also. So target 6.2 of sustainable development goals calls for countries to end open defecation going out in for excreta and ensure everyone has access to basic toilet and place system for safe management of excreta. So basic toilets access and management of excreta is also important with respect to sanitation and hygiene, so that to avoid diseases. Our next news is, so first see the five themes what he has said. That first one is ensure people leading the planning, implementation and management of sanitation programs. Next is use smart and affordable technologies for effective and efficient. We can see here, this is important, effective and efficient service delivery. Third is eliminate all forms of inequality in service delivery, that discriminating someone for not taking this, and basically it's against discrimination. And fourth is create innovative financing instruments to fund and sustain sanitation movement. And the last one is of the five themes, develop capacities within the government to plan, implement and monitor sanitation programs. So if we are going to write any essay, then we can write all these five themes. Our next news is Mera School Digital School Program. Basically here Vice President of India was giving a speech where he was addressing 100 digital classrooms in 75 government schools in Gwalior, Madhya Pradesh, under Mera School Digital School Program, where he said, technology brings transparency, prosperity and opportunities for rural youth. So nowadays, India is focusing basically on digital technology for generating employment for the rural and urban both. Next is exercise Yuddhabhyas. So we have seen that Yuddhabhyas concluded, and it was a military joint military exercise between India and US, and which was concluded at Chaubatia, Uttarakhand on 29th, that is yesterday. So it can be asked that Yuddhabhyas is related to which two countries? Then it is related to India and US, and mainly it's a military exercise. Next news is SIDA. What it stands for? It stands for Center of Excellence for Data Analytics. So NIC, National Informatics Center, and NIC Service Incorporated, NICSI, jointly set up this SIDA. And let's see about something about SIDA. The center aims to support government departments to unlock what? To unlock the hidden potential of data that they are generating as a part of governance processes and use it to improve the overall governance. So basically here, as the name suggests, Center for Excellence for Data Analytics. So here the data will be analysis. Data analysis will be done, and its function is it shall provide quality data analytic service. This will be provided to government departments at all levels. At all levels, it's not at any specific level, it will be provided to all levels, identifying appropriate tools and technologies and deploying people with right expertise. So SETA will be used for this data analysis. Our next news is Typhoon Trami. This typhoon, as you can see here image, it hit Japan's southern island of Okinawa. So it can be asked that Okinawa is situated where? It's in Japan, and it's an island of Japan. Here this typhoon Trami hit and injured at least nine were injured. As weather official warned, the storm would rip through the Japanese archipelago is a group of islands, and over the weekend, means it is going to enter in other islands also, and some 600 people evacuated to shelter in Okinawa, and electricity was cut nearly 2 lakh homes. So they are facing problem. Next is Vayu. Vayu stands for Wind Augmentation Purifying Unit. We have discussed about this earlier also. Today let's see in detail. Vayu is developed by CSIR NEERI. CSIR stands for Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, and NEERI stands for National Environmental Engineering Research Institute, as a part of technology development project under DST, Department of Science Technology. Fund was given by this department, and its capacity is to purify air in an area of 500 meter square. So let's see how it works. First is two principles on which it will work. First is wind generation for dilution of air pollutants, and second is active pollutant removal. And it will filter particulate matter removal and activated charcoal. So it will, by this, filter the air, purify the air. And this device has one fan and filter for sucking and removing particulate matter. So this device will be used for purifying the air, and it's first is established in Delhi only. Next is Sushma Swaraj during UNGS speech. UNGS stands for United Nations General Assembly. So Sushma Swaraj was giving speech in UNG Assembly, and he said terrorists are called freedom fighters in Pakistan. Sushma Swaraj hits out at Islamabad during UNGS speech. So here our External Affairs Minister said that it was the 73rd session of UNGA, and she blamed Pakistan for spreading terrorism in India. She said after the end of 20th century, there was a hope for peace in 21st century. But terror attacks like 9/11 and 26/11 have disappointed us. So he pointed out on these two attacks. These were very fatal attacks in the history of mankind. So he said that these two attacks disappointed us. Today the monster of terrorism is progressing. Next is, it's a section of miscellaneous. Our first miscellaneous news is Assam government will launch universal pension scheme in the state on 22nd. 22nd is the birthday of Mahatma Gandhi. On this day, Assam will launch universal pension scheme. Second is New Delhi will host. Which city will host? New Delhi will host what? It will host second global reinvest from 3rd to 5th of October. As you can see here, here's sun, it's wind vane, it's something like ocean, and it's here you can see green. So it's basically about, this convention is about the green energy formation. And in this section of on this day, our first is 1862. In 1862, Prussia Minister President Otto von Bismarck, we have heard his name many a times, Bismarck, delivered his blood and iron speech. So if it's the question asked like blood and iron speech related to whom, then its answer will be Otto von Bismarck. And second is in 1971, what? The Soviet Union and United States signed pact that were aimed at avoiding is important, what? Accidental nuclear war. So Soviet Union, USSR and United States signed in 1971 a pact to avoid accidental nuclear war. So here we have two things in on this day. These were the two important things that happened in the history. So by this we came to the end of this video. So guys, please, if you like our work, then please like, share and subscribe to our channel and tell your friends so that they will also be benefited from this. Thank you.